Hi guys, this is my Tradescantia Brevifolia, also known as the Green Queen. I am very delayed in regards to vlogging in for this plant. I didn't even know I had this plant. I think I kind of assumed this was a part of the Blushing Bride or the Tradescantia Blushing Bride. And it's not because the leaves are different, the size of the stems or branches are different. They're much skinnier, the leaves are much smaller. So, supposedly this is a green queen, and supposedly this does flower. I have yet to see it flower. Also, I'm not really providing it with any kind of flowering or bloom supplement because I just want her to kind of grow more. And I mean, that can definitely change. But everything as usual in regards to my plant vlogs, I always put everything that I do use to water this particular plant in the description section. Also, in my description section is my social media account. So if you want to connect in my other platforms, it's right there. I hope you enjoy the rest of my video. You can hit the like, subscribe, and of course, the bell so you're notified every single time I do upload a new video. So this currently is being watered every 14 days. She sits in a 6-inch pot, and I am using just regular potting soil, nothing fancy. My current favorite soil brand is Schultz potting soil for indoor plants. I completely love that. I don't have any problems with it. No pests, no issues in it holding too much water that can actually kill my plants. It's pretty fast draining. I would say it's even more fast draining than Miracle-Gro's cactus soil, so I really love it. This sits in front of a west-facing window, and it used to be, I would say about a month ago, it used to be behind about two plants before the window. So I would say it would be about 2 to 3 feet in 2 to 3 feet away from a window, with two plants kind of giving a lot more shade for her. I mean, she does get the light, but there are plants in front of her, so she's not really accessing that right now. I mean, before I did move her closer to the window. She's in a different spot now, and again, watering her every 14 days. So just so you know, everybody's environment is going to be slightly different. The way I made my schedule is I water her when the top, I would say top, at least 1 to 2 inches. I would say at least 1 inch is completely dry. So when I stick my finger in there, no soil is going to come back out, and I don't feel any dampness or moisture or anything. If you kind of want to toy with yours, I would say at least minimum is 1 inch. If you want to make it drier, that's fine too. Just so you know, the drier it is, you have to watch out if the leaves turn yellow, if it indicates it's being overwatered, and if you're making it completely dry out, sometimes the volume might be a little too much. You gotta think about it like if it was a person and it was dehydrated for how many days, you can't give it a gallon of water. You have to administer the water very slowly, so the volume has to be kind of minimal. This is a very hardy plant. I would say if you want to try Tradescantia family, this is definitely one of those that it would be very hard to kill. This is definitely a beginner plant. Before you want to try the much more flashier ones, like the Flumineniensis Nanook, Flumineniensis Lilac, the Albiflora, or the Tricolor, or the what other plant? They're all Albiflora. Albiflora is also called Rainbow. Albiflora is also called like Multicolor, Tricolor, stuff like that. That's all the Albiflora. Due to the variegation and the very heavy variegation of those, it can be a little trickier. So if you want to try to wet your feet in regards to the Tradescantia family, this is definitely one of those that is very easy to care for. She grows like a weed for me. So far, I try and always test my plants and how much they can handle and what they can and cannot handle. And that is really how you learn on how to take care of a specific plant. Each plant is going to be slightly different, and this one is pretty tough and resilient. So I would really suggest this. I would say I have kept this in a west-facing window. I have never kept this in an east-facing window. I have a ton of Tradescantias, and they also thrive in an east-facing window. What I would be more concerned of if you do put this in a south-facing window and they start to burn, I would say take it away from that because supposedly Tradescantias are not really into full sun. When they are out in the wild, they are usually a ground cover, which they do get some shade. So I wouldn't really suggest a south-facing window, even indirect, due to the midday sun, which is the hottest. You have to understand that the south-facing window is the most intense, the strongest light out of four directions. Next would be the west, and the east and the north is the darkest or the less intense out of all four. I have not tried this in a north-facing window. I have limited north-facing windows. I have majority west and east. And this particular Tradescantia, as I've mentioned, has never been in an east-facing window. It has just been in a west-facing window. Initially, my Tradescantias were in a west-facing window. Some of them burnt, so I did move them to an east-facing window. This one didn't, so I'm keeping her on a west-facing window. If you guys have any questions, comments, suggestions about this particular plant, you want to chit-chat about this particular plant, let me know in the comment section down below. Also, a little bit of information. This was actually just like one clipping. This was given to me like free for one of my purchases. And now she sits in her own 6-inch pot. All I really did was clip her and propagate her, and that has been about a year. About a year from now. So it took me about at least 6 months maybe to clip and propagate because she's not variegated. Her growth is really, really quick. So with that, let's just say it started with a one, right? And I clipped it, and then I propagated those, and I clipped everything again when they started to grow and grow and grow and grow. And now, it has filled a 6-inch pot from one clipping. What I did use for the propagation and the clipping, I will try to put that in the description section. If I do forget to add that in there, please do mention it in the comment section below so I can update that on what I did use in regards to growing and what I did use to water or use with the water with it. And this is definitely one of the fastest growing in regards to from clipping to having its own root system. So if you want to try and test and experiment in regards to clipping and propagation, and you want to get and try it with this plant, I could just tell you that I have failed in propagation and growing without any roots, and this is definitely 100% success rate for me. So if you're one of those people that have had issues before, like I have in other plants and other varieties and other species, if you want to try and boost your confidence, this is definitely one of them. This is not a very popular common of the Tradescantia family. I think because it's not very flashy, it's just plain green. The Fluminensis varieties are definitely more popular ones because they have pink, purple, white kind of variations, and those really kind of attract a lot more people that are into variegated plants. If you're not into variegated plants, this is definitely something that is just something to add to your collection if you want to. Again, if there's anything else, let me know down in the comment section. I love you guys so much. Thank you for the love and support. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.